I went downstairs to grab some juice of a poke, flipped the coming from behind. He said,
"Don't
go fibbing, little lady,
now you must die."
And I ain't even waiting to see who it was. Broke inside my brawl, it's been so long, cuz got halfway up the block, I calmed down and stopped speaking with the thought. I must have been getting thrown back home with the thrill of my thrill. I've been to synthesis, I might as well get ill. I walked in the house, the big bad fresh prince, but Freddy killed all that noise real quick. He grabbed me by my neck and said,
"Here's my bill. We got a lot of work here, me and you. The souls of your friends, you and I will claim. You've got the body and I got the brain."
I said, "Yo, Fred, I think you got me all wrong. I ain't partners with nobody with nails that long. Look, I'll be honest, man, this team won't work. The girls won't be on you, Fred, their faces all burned." I pat him on the shoulder, said, "Thank you for stopping by." Then I opened up the door and said, "Hey, that guy, he got mad, he let me run. The slash my shirt. I ran at first, I thought, hold up, that hurt. It wasn't a dream, man, this got me for real." I said,
change.
our souls.
Other's thoughts. In this way, our minds were locked together. Minds locked together. Minds locked together. Minds locked together. Thoughts. In this way, our minds were locked together so that at the proper time, we would both be drawn to Kunut Khalifi. Kunut Khalifi.
put a gun in my mouth and blew away my vast knowledge.
Valley of Pain.
Yeah. of my family have fallen into madness.
trembles. They're gonna eat me alive. If I stumble.
Remember the incredible conformists. You have to remember the incredible conformists. You have to remember the incredible conformists.
To inform you about the people or persons out there digging up bodies to have sex with them.
Get through this part quickly, Lord, and then on to the revenge.
be born and a time to die.
Time to
embrace
and a time to refrain from embracing.
Time to build up and a time to tear down.
A time to love
and a time to hate. A time to kill, burn, bludgeon, and
Yeah. of Satan.
Veritas te liberandum.
This black man was homosexual, immoral, on drugs, the worst kind of person. Homosexual, on drugs, homosexual, on drugs, homosexual, on drugs.
Drugs. Quite sadly, but there's a few minutes left. And I held my neck.
Hardcore spirits forever. And
is that true? Those odds are fucking some stupid assholes in the mind, or people that are fucking that have the bosses to say something in your face when you're doing your fucking mind. This is propaganda!
Thank you.
that they will find the same peace I am looking for. Mr. Boyle's associates, Wendy and Ellen, have been wonderful to me, helping me through this worst of all times. I want to publicly thank Mr. Boyle. He didn't need to take this case. But when I asked him to help me find the answers and to help others, if I could, he stayed with me and went way overboard in trying to help me. Mr. Boyle and I agreed that it was never a matter of trying to get off. It was only a matter of which place I would be housed the rest of my life, not for my comfort, but for trying to study me in the hopes of helping me to help others who might have problems. I know I will be in prison. I pledge to talk to doctors who might be able to find some answers. In closing, I just want to say that I hope God has forgiven me. I know society will never be able to forgive me. I know the families of the victims will never be able to forgive me for what I have done. I promise I will pray each day to ask for their forgiveness when the hurt goes away, if ever. I have seen their tears, and if I could give my life right now to bring their loved ones back, I would do it. I am so very sorry. Your Honor, I know that you are about to sentence me. I ask for no consideration. I want you to know that I have been treated perfectly by the deputies who have been in your court and the deputies who work at the jail. The deputies have treated me very professionally, and I want everyone to know that. They have not given me special treatment. Here is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. But for that very reason I was shown mercy, so that in me, the worst of sinners, Christ Jesus might display his unlimited patience as an example for those who would believe in him and receive an eternal life. Now to the King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. I know my time in prison will be terrible, but I deserve whatever I get because of what I have done. Thank you, Your Honor, and I am prepared for your sentence, which I know will be the maximum. I ask for no consideration.
Count 15. Life imprisonment with parole eligibility to be 70 years after the inception of that sentence to be consecutive to count 14. I intended to follow the recommendation of the state. I could have said something different which would have had the same impact. I really see nobody gains anything by just to say more and more years. The important point is that the sentence is structured in such a way that this defendant will never again see freedom. That is owed to this community in order to protect the community, as well as acknowledgement of the seriousness of the offenses. Those are the reasons. The sentence, of course, is to the state prison system. One thing I didn't provide, all of these sentences are consecutive to the time he's presently serving.
What was your client's reaction? What was your reaction to the statements of the families before today, and particularly the outburst?
Well, let me tell you about all of them. I think they were, those people showed great dignity today. And even the lady and her outburst was most expected. I had anticipated that maybe there would be more of that. But the outburst, in my opinion, was appropriate. I always try and judge other people by what I would do in the same or similar circumstances.
Hey, listen!
No.